This morning, by the Spirit of God, I want to share with us the topic the Spirit of God put in my spirit to use to liberate so many families and to break every stubborn yokes and chains in our lives. The topic is withhold me not. Withhold me not. In this service, anything that is holding you, that has been holding you, they have been allowed to release you in the name of Jesus. In this service, anything that has been holding you down without your knowledge, anything that has been binding you without your knowledge, anything that refuses to go forward without your knowledge, any powers that have been blocking you, standing on your way without knowing, as a spiritual police, as a demonic obstacle, in this service by the Spirit of God, those unseen obstacles are cleared out of your destiny in the name of Jesus. The anointing that is present in this service is present to destroy various kinds of yokes. Today's service, it told me, I want to clear every demonic obstacles. I want to clear out every witchcraft hold up in your life. Any area you are being hold up that you are not aware of, you are aware of. Today, you'll be released in the name of Jesus. Every expectation that you are due for that has been on hold for years, I'm here to announce to you, if you have entered here mistakenly, by the same mistake, the anointing will release them to you. You're all welcome in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, for giving me a mouth and a wisdom that all my adversaries cannot be able to gainsay nor resist. And I'm taking my text from Job 12:15. Very, very swift. Job 12:15. Behold, he withholdeth the waters, and they do what? They dry up. Anytime something is withheld in your life, know that waters, resources, so many things will be dried up. Let me have Job 38:15. Whatsoever the wicked has holding that has caused dryness in your life, in your family, in your finance, I command a forceful release in the name of Jesus. He said, from the wicked their light is withholding, and the high arm shall be what? Broken. Every light of the wicked against you, every light of witchcraft against your life, by which they see through to operate wickedness, by a decree in the name of Jesus, their arms are broken off your destiny in Jesus' name. Any hand that have been devising your heart, any hand that you see not that be causing your pain, any hand that is sponsoring trouble, calamity and shame in your life, in this service right now, I command those hands to be broken in the name of Jesus. He said in Psalm 21 verse 2, he said, thou hast given him his heart desire. In this service, your heart desire will come swiftly in Jesus' name, and has not withholding the request of his lips. So in this service, your heart desires shall be granted and released speedily in the name of Jesus Christ. No more shall your request be withheld in the name of Jesus. Any force in the air, any force on the land, any force beneath the earth, any forces from your father's house, from your mother's house, from your husband's father's house, from your compound that be withholding your request, I decree, let those forces receive destruction by the Spirit of God. Shout 2 times, say, my desires are granted. Again. Amen. The Bible said in Psalm 84 verse 11, I love this one. Psalm 84 verse 11. He said, for the Lord God is a sun and shield for us. The Lord will give grace and glory to us all the days of August. He said, and not only that, no good thing. Tell your neighbor, no good thing. Say, no good thing. With Jehovah, with God, withhold from them that walk uprightly. Baba God is saying, I've not withhold anything from you. We are ready for that wickedness. Any power that be withholding what has not, God has not withheld, let those powers be crucified now. Finally, Proverbs 3:27. Note those texts that where we will be going through. Proverbs 3:27, the grand finale. He said, withhold not good for them to whom it is due. Withhold not what? Good. Withhold not what? stars, withhold not not visa, withhold not what marriage, we go, just be selling, withhold not not my womb, withhold not members of Arena of Miracle, withhold not. Give me half the scripture. Withhold not good. That thing that is good. That thing that will make you celebrate. That thing that will make crowd to gather to rejoice with you. Any hand withholding it, let those hands be withheld. This scream is not showing. Please, I told you correct these things before service start. This scream is not showing. He said, withhold not good from them to whom it is due when it is in the power of their hand to do it. You should not withhold it. Any force that is living inside of your body, any demonic authority that is sleeping with you in your house, being an enemy without your knowledge, that be hearing all your conversation, that be withholding, that have assigned powers to block answers from coming to you, I decree, assign destruction to waste them in the places of assignment. Let fire waste them in the places of assignment. Whosoever my God hath not assigned to favor me, whosoever the powers of darkness have assigned to withhold my answers, to withhold my breakthrough, to withhold my husband from coming, my wife from coming, to withhold good things from me, I decree, let fire roast them in the place of their evil assignments. In this service, he that must die must die. I say, in this service, he that must die must die. She that must die must die. And your good things are releasing in Jesus. The meaning of the word withhold. Let's be seated. We are working with time. Seriously. The meaning of the word withhold. Withhold, it means to head back. To head back from action, from happening, or from receiving. It means to do what? To head back from action, from happening, or from what? Receiving. It also means, is to mean, the second meaning of it is to keep in custody. That is to imprison something. To prison, when somebody is in prison, when somebody's destiny is in prison, when somebody is in prison, nothing is working. Check out the people that is in prison, their business, their everything about them is on standstill. So when somebody's destiny is in custody of any kind, nothing is working. Nothing is happening. When you notice that your nothing is working in your life, job is not working, finance is not working, children, so many things are not working, it's only you that is moving up and down. Know that that destiny has been withheld. And I'm here to announce any destiny that is locked up in a prison. I decree the Lord of hosts himself, let him visit that demonic prison. Let him release your destiny from that prison now. The Bible said when God turned the captivity of Job, when he turned the captivity of men, it was like that dreams. I decree in this service, any captivity you are into, knowing and unknowingly, they shall be turned around in the name of Jesus. I want you to know officially that anything I say is what God do. It's good you know that. This place is a place of the Spirit of God. Anything I say is what the Spirit of God say, do. And I don't say what I want to say. I say what he make me to say. Is that okay? So be very, very attentive in the word. Once your own come, hold it and write it down and run with it. Is that okay? Now, I say to withhold also mean the third definition is to refrain or refuse from granting or giving or allowing. Is to refrain. To withhold means to refrain somebody from having something, refuse somebody from getting something, from granting something to somebody, from giving something. When somebody is under the power of refrain, or something is refusing you, anywhere you turn to, they will tell you no. It can be doing, once it gets to your turn, it's finished. You are withdrawing money once it gets, if you are standing on a queue, you are with your ATM, you are withdrawing money, and money got to your time, money finished, it might not be bad. But when it happens one or two times, something is wrong. Nothing, good things must not finish when you get there. Say, good things cannot finish when I get there. Say, good things will be in abundance when I get there. So when you are always experiencing once it's your turn, things begin to go wrong. That shows that that person is under what? Powers that are restraining him. And anyone that is bearing such mark of refusal, mark of no man giving to you, any man that is bearing such mark, I hear the word mark, you'll be marked by winches that no man will give to you, that when you ask, it can never be granted. Once you apply for a job, that is when the company will close down. I decree, let such witchcraft mark be erased from you by the blood of Jesus. And I place the mark of acceptance on your head in the name of Jesus. Shout 2 times, I'm accepted. Again, it is done. So to withhold also mean number 4, it means to deny. When somebody is being denied often, anything you ask, I don't have it. Anything you have, if you come back 10 minutes later, anything you ask, if you have been here 20 minutes ago, everything is denying the person. There are powers that are responsible for making men to refuse men. There are demons that are responsible for making people to be denied of every request they make. And I decree, let such demon hear in my voice. Let them pack their load and get out from your family. I command such demons that are responding denier of requests in your destiny. I command them right now to pack out of your family, pack out of your destiny, pack out of your life in the name of Jesus. Now, to withhold also means to hinder. It means to do what? To hinder. When somebody is hindered, nothing work. When somebody is hindered, the person is resisted. When somebody is hindered, nothing is working. I'm telling you, nothing is working. A person that is often hindered is always crying. A person that is often hindered is always sorrowing. A person that is often hindered is under depressed. A person that is often hindered is always borrowing. And I decree every power that be ordained to hinder your expectation, to hinder your request, to hinder good things from coming to you, in the places of hindrance, I assign fire to roast those demons. I command your path to be cleared in the name of Jesus. I decree no good thing shall the wicked hinder in your life, in Jesus' name. Now, the next definition of to withhold is to ban. Is to do what? To ban. And you say, when we talk about ban, the right word to use is embargo. The right word to, when you talk about ban, the right word to use is what? Embargo. Once you talk about embargo, you understand ban very well. Once the federal government said that have banned using a certain product, you see everybody will walk away from that product. Because once they say it, they have enforced regulatory boundaries. And these regulatory boundaries in the spiritual realm are called demons. And what is the assignment of the physical regulatory boundary? Any person that they purchase that product, what would they do? They will pound on the person and arrest the person and arrest the goods for their usage, or even submit it. Are you getting what I'm saying? So when somebody's destiny, when a womb is under embargo, that womb cannot conceive. Anytime that womb wants to conceive, when it's time for ovulation, it will be visited by demons in the dream. He or she will fight with demons until the ovulation is passed. Are you getting me? When somebody is under demonic embargo, satanic restriction, a regulatory order has been placed on the person. Anytime how do they say it again? You apply for a job. Once is the day, the night before the interview, it will be war in your dream. You will see yourself fighting with people. You will fight something, you fight and wake up. When such is going on in your life, know that demonic embargo has been placed on you. Don't eat akara with it. Something is seriously wrong in your life. There are demonic regulatory boundaries that others has been given, that he cannot cross over that line, that he cannot get this job, that he cannot marry such family, that he cannot get such favor. Are you getting me? Anyone that even dare to favor them at times, they attack them. The same way the federal government, if they pound to anyone you distribute the goods, they go to do what? Attack the person to retrieve the goods. Am I making sense to somebody's spirit? That is what we call satanic embargoes. When somebody is on demonic ban, nothing is working. Nobody comes to do business with you. Nobody nobody comes to help you. Nobody comes to assist you, because when they come to assist, they too will be attacked. Some people have said that I went to help and that is how I lost my job. Have you seen people that said such thing? I went to assist and that is where they have accident. Have you seen people that said such thing? I went to, why? It's the power, because the person is under demonic embargo. When you want to help people under demonic embargo, you yourself must be an authority. Authority means you have a higher power, a higher order has been given to you to rule over others. Am I making sense to somebody this morning? And I'm decreeing this morning, every demonic authority that have placed a witchcraft embargo on your destiny, by higher authority, I destroy those orders in your life. I command those regulatory to catch fire in your destiny. Wherever you are bound by the authority I have in the name of Jesus, I declare you release. Wherever your destiny is on hold, I command it to be released. By the authority in the name of Jesus, I lose you wherever you are bound in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout authority. Somebody shout authority. That is where we operate. The Bible told me in Luke 9:1. He said, behold, he has given me power and authority over every regulatory powers and others, over every devil. He said to cast them out and to heal all manner of diseases and sicknesses. I hereby announce to you, any family under witchcraft order, I command, let the authority of God destroy the head witch against your family. I decree, let the restriction catch fire against your destiny. Let the restriction catch fire against your job. Let demonic embargo be destroyed off your marriage. In the name of Jesus, every witchcraft order restraining destiny helpers from helping your husband, from helping you, from refusing helpers to come your way, I decree those orders, let them catch fire. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I command the release of destiny helpers into your life. Is he entering at all? So I cannot be restricted. When somebody, a shop is restricted, no customer comes there. When a house is under, a project is under an embargo, that's why some of us don't have sense at all. You start a building, you didn't involve your pastor. Don't dig the ground without dropping a seed on the altar. And carry a seed that costs you something. Even if it's a house you wanted to build like crawling, it's a house that you didn't keep money. You are building. But first gather a seed and go to God. Make yourself Baba God. You are the greatest authority. I'm about to go into this project. Fight every unseen battles for me. Kill them that want to kill this project. Waste them that want, those that want to waste the source of this project. Are you getting me? Any force that stay in that environment, such building will not come up. Let my sacrifice kill them. You drop them and walk away. That is how the wise. You have introduced your projects to the God that is higher than the highest. You have introduced your project to a God that is what? Higher than the highest. He's higher than everything. Let them come by rain, he will crush them. Let them come by the sun, he will waste them. Let them come from underneath, he will bring them down. Why? Because he has eaten your sacrifice. Somebody say wisdom. There are projects you don't go into without dropping a seed. You don't move into a new shop without dropping a seed. You don't move into a hulu house without carrying a seed and drop at the altar. This house I'm entering, oh God, anything that bring men down, let it take me up. This house I'm going to, oh God, anything that take life here, let it preserve me in the life of my children. This house I'm going to by my sacrifice. From here, promote me to my own property. Am I talking to somebody's spirit? You don't enter like an unbeliever and just carry your bag and carry money fresh and wash how do they call it, house. And tell your friends, come and eat and drink. I mean, no, you don't do that. That's how an unbeliever think. When they enter, they begin to go down, 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 down. So many things you are seeing, you don't know the foundation of them. You don't know, and nobody will tell you until you begin to see things. So when somebody, a business is under restriction, nobody comes to buy. Nobody comes to buy. You will shake, but nobody will come there. Am I talking to your spirit? When your job is under embargo, it begin to dry up. Everybody begin to find offense with you in the office. Before you know it, they will sack you. Why? Because a restriction has been placed on that person that the source must close. And I'm here to announce, any witchcraft course on the source of your family that have introduced loss of job, that have introduced loss of personal helper, any power that will attack you because of the source, because of the sources of making money in your family, so that your source will dry up, I decree in the name of Jesus, let such demonic force be crushed in your destiny. Wherever the cause is existing, I command the cause to be turned to a blessing. I command your resources to break forth. I command the fountain of your resources to blossom. In the name of Jesus, shout 2 times, my resources cannot dry up. Again. But it will overflow in the name of Jesus. Be seated. When somebody is under embargo, nobody favors you. No, nobody favors. When a church is under embargo, members don't come. And when they manage to come, they feel as if you are doing them a favor. They are doing you a favor. Are you getting me? When your body is under embargo, you are always sick. Every minute you are sick. You are even privileged. You can have a place that demons will be leaving your body every time. But it's good you know that your health is under what? Embargo. If you check it very well, you're always having demonic visitors in the night. Am I talking to somebody? You're always having demonic visitors, confrontations. Are you getting me? Fighting battles that nobody is seeing. It shows that your health is under siege. And I decree, let the anointing that is present right now crush every power that's tormenting and oppressing your body, oppressing your spirit. Let the fire of God waste the oppressors in the name of Jesus. What empowers? Before I go there, when somebody is under embargo, the person cannot pass. Nothing allow you to pass. The way of the person is blocked. And I decree, every being that you see not, that stands on your way, that refuses you to pass to the other side of life, that refuses you to cross to the other side of life, any kind of giant they are that you are not aware of, I decree, let the Lord of hosts himself, let the mighty man of battle himself, with his mighty sword that is drew out of his shield, I decree, let it call down those invisible giants in the name of Jesus. I command you to pass over in the name of Jesus. Some not stand still. Some making progress. Yes, I like the way you let the one sitting, let them be sitting. What empowers Satan to withhold one? What empowers Satan to withhold one? Number one, sin. There is something that empowers Satan. There's something, a car cannot move until you put fuel. So there's something that accelerates Satan to do these things. On his own, Satan have no power over you as a believer. Number one is what? Sin. The Bible says in Jeremiah 5:25. He said, your iniquities have turned away good things from you, and your sins have what? Withholding good things from you. So sins, immoral living, Facebook, all manner of immoral living, social platform kinds of immoral living, watching blue movies, watching things that defy the spirit, practicing all kind of wickedness. On Sunday, by the Spirit of God, the word of God put a word of message in my mouth concerning abominable things. Were you blessed by that teaching? Go and listen to that thing. It talked about false balance. It talked about so many abominable things that men are doing. Gay, lesbianism, all manner. You can't practice in such thing and you will not be withheld. The reason why devil suggests all these lifestyles to you, tell you fornicate as you want. When you marry, you cannot be born again. You can't be born again now because you have to be testing different man. Not only that, to see that their headquarters is performing, but also see if their pocket is also loaded. So you keep on testing. And you don't know that as you are testing, what you are using to test them is going weaker. It's going what? Both the headquarter and the down quarter. It's going what? Weaker. And by the time the morning you wake up and discover both the headquarter and the down quarter is weaker, you now realize yourself, I'm tired of testing. Anyone can come, let me marry. And at times, anyone is not available. At times, anyone is what? It's not available. Sin. He says, sin withholds good things from you. Get out from it. Iniquities. Practicing of all sort of wickedness. Get out from it. Lying. Stealing. Plotting to steal. Perjuring. Evil jestings. Jesting that bring insult to the presence of God. Get out from them. The Bible said the wages of sin is what? Death. The only salary sin we pay you at the end is what? Death. It doesn't pay anything. So get out from it. There is no blessing in a sin. Once you start sinning, you are in enmity with God. You are in enmity with the earth. I read a particular scripture in Leviticus. He said, the people that I chase out, that I'm bringing you in, these are the evils that they did that made the earth to rise up against them. I was sharing with somebody. I have a neighbor that started building next to my house. I've been looking for him to see him. He started building and went to do a fence on top of the gutter. Immediately I came out, I see it. God told me, this is why the water speak against men. The earth rise up against men. You have your own land. The one they created for just water. You know, I hope you know water is a spirit. I hope you know earth is a spirit. Where they create for water, your past, see where man, you went to build on top of it. He said, you see this thing? He cannot prosper in this project. But some of you that think you are wise, you will build and build enter main road. You will build and encroach into another person's compound. You will see the Bible say you should not remove landmarks. At times when you see some things, that's why God says so. Gota. Now you go build a house on top of Gota. It's wickedness. I used to tell people, if you want to know somebody's heart, you know somebody's heart by driving. Did you hear what I just said? No, you don't know yourself. You know yourself when you are driving. Because when you are driving, you don't talk. It's your heart that you are driving. Use somebody driving to know his or her heart. If you can come and see somebody gate and just park your motor and just walk away. You saw an entrance, you just park. You don't feel anything, walk away. I was standing in a bank. How many weeks ago, me and my son, he went to assist me to correct something. And we were standing in a line. We came, they said somebody is there. I said, okay, what if he said nobody is there? I wonder, you know, they said somebody is there. I said, okay, how are we going to? I said, okay, let me start my son. So he said, I should know where I should stand. Once it's my turn, he said, let him stand and be feeling what he's feeling. I see. A man came with a woman. Bang, 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 came. They told her the same thing they told me. He said, told the woman, I better stay where you say. He said, somebody is standing here. They just went to feel. He said, mind your business. He said, behold, not up to 10 minutes, the person that stood there came. Share your ear, the locker. I was watching two of them. He said, she did told this woman that somebody is standing here. She went even asked her son or her brother, your ear, they lock up. You get said, how will you get out from there? You know, foolishly worked out. And now the line is full. Oh, you know what? He now went back. So smartness at times they are foolishness. Get out from sin. Get out from what? Sin. Number two, what empowers Satan to withhold what? Not being born again. Colossians 1:13 to 14. He said, for God, when you are born again, God will deliver you from, tell your neighbor, from the power of who? Darkness. When nothing is working in your life, you are under the control, under the custody, under the kingdom, domain of darkness. He said, he will deliver you from the power of what? Darkness. And translate you into the kingdom. Return it back, I'm talking. Translate it into the kingdom of his dear son of love, in whom you have redemption, verse 14, through his blood. Even what? The forgiveness of sin. Your sins will be cleared out of your way. Those sins you committed that is standing, that is making good things to be withheld from you, Jesus Christ will use his blood and pay the price of those your sins and remove them. You will stand as if justified, as if you have never sinned before. To enable you enjoy the good things of God. As long as sin is standing before you, no good thing come to you. The only way good thing will come to you is that you steal the people's money, as we are seeing that is going on in Nigeria. The Bible told us the wages of sin is what? Death. Job 20:15 says, even if you swallow it, you think it's everybody that prospers that is God. Every prosperity is not God. You can't break the ways of God. Some people go do and that is why you look as if evil is continuing. Because people say, leave that thing you are preaching righteousness today, you go give me food. This one where you're thief and since 20 years, are they not prospering? We are not seeing the end of it, because this is the end of the age. A new age is about to start. We are seeing it now. There's a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof is what? Destruction. You might think you are prospering, but the end is shame. You cannot prosper in sin. It's not God. Stop deceiving yourself. If you like, do rituals and pretend and give offering and give scholarship and do all manner deceiving people. You're a church while you are a courtship. Don't worry, your cup will soon fill. The Bible says your sin one day will do what? Find you out. And what he will use to find you up out is a very simple thing that the world will say, now this simple thing, I can't expose this man. I can't expose this woman. Very simple. You can't escape the trap of God. So you must be born again. The Bible says in John 3:19. He said, and this is the condemnation, that light is coming to the world. And men love what? Darkness rather than what? Light. Because of their what? These are what? Evil. Light is coming to the world, but people love darkness. He said, I'm the light of the world. Anyone that followeth me, that walk with me, shall not walk in darkness. They say, no. That one, now when Jesus can appear, they make a look for any means where they survive now. Right? Now the means we're on top of now. It's not prosperity everywhere. It's not every prosperity you see that is godly. No matter how you come and they give you front chair to sit in the church, it's not godly. Now stop this. You know the things you are doing is evil, so quit from it. Is that okay? So get out from it. You can write down Acts 26:18. It says, why do you want you to be born again? So that you'll be brought out of darkness to light. So you be brought out from the power of Satan to the power of Christ. Number three, what empowers Satan to withhold you? Number three, lack of knowledge. Lack of what? Knowledge. You know not and you don't want to know. Psalm 82:5-8. He said, they know not. They do what? They know not. Oh God. Dio. They know not. He said, they know not. Neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness. All the foundations of their life are out of what? Order. Out of course. I have said, you are what? Gods. And all of you are the children of who? The Most High God. But you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes if you refuse to know your place as God. Because of time, let's go. Is that okay? You must have knowledge. The Bible says in Proverbs 11:9b. I love that scripture too much. Say, true knowledge shall the just be what? Delivered. True knowledge will be delivered. He put it like this again in Proverbs 3:20. I love this one again. He said, true knowledge shall the dead be broken up. An answer will come to you. The two will release their blessing. True knowledge shall the depths, the deep, the hidden thing will break up. And you have freedom of your destiny in the name of Jesus. Number four. What empowers Satan? Are you following me at all? Yes. What empowers Satan to withhold one? Number four, withholding that of God and man. Somebody say that the written now. Withholding that of God and man. The Bible says in Proverbs 11:26, give it to me. It says, he that withholdeth the corn, the people shall curse. But blessing shall be upon of him that giveth it or selleth it. Anytime you withhold, curse is upon you. You will hold children's people's salary. Federal government gave them salary that they should pay them to 200,000. And because you think it's agriculture department, nobody know much about it. You decide to pay them 80,000 and siphon 100,000+. And your stomach is as big as trailer. Because of destiny you are eating. Federal government will give money for military, for police, and say pay social compensation of the children. Were the children there in the meeting? No. Were they the way federal government signing? No. Any person to give evidence that they said no, it's only you. So you ate it and your belly is swollen. And Job 2015 is your portion. Job, give it to me, 2015. He's saying you have eaten up the riches of children under military, under police, under government. He said you have eaten it. Give me the scripture. He said you vomit it out and God will cast it out of your belly by force. You must vomit it. You must vomit it. He has swallowed down the riches of the poor, the weak, those that are not in authority that saw when they gave you the money. As they give you, you share, you give some percentage to some people that cannot talk. Only you will eat it. And your bellies are big as this. He said, you have swallowed it, no problem. He said, but you will vomit it up again. And who will cast it? God will cast it out of your belly. Somebody say, I hear. It's not everything you swallow. Anytime you swallow what is not yours. Oh God. You can imagine snakes swallowing lion. So withholding that of God and man, we have seen it in Proverbs 3:27. Proverbs what? 3:27. He says you should not withhold. Proverbs 3:27, please help me to make that person there to give me scriptures fast. Withhold not good from them to whom it is what? Due, when it is in the power of their hand to do it. Give me 28. Don't say to him, go, come back tomorrow, when it is in their hand. The next verse is just verse 28. Say not thou unto thy neighbor, go, the person that came to ask you, and come again, and tomorrow I will give you where you have it there by day. It's wickedness. I'm not going to give you. You won't give you, open your purse. You change. What you are looking for is 15 naira. That's what every time you come to church, you are looking for the small denomination to give to God. And here you are, it's the same God you came to cry to help me. But when it comes to giving, you give him small. When it comes to answering you, you answer big prayer. You withhold that which is God, and you want God to release your own. How now? How? When he said to you, release your first fruit, you will not. Proverbs 3:9 and 10. When you release your first fruit, what will happen? He said, I will make your barns be filled with what? Plenty. And it will burst with what? New wine. No opportunity will emerge. But give your first fruit. He said, I will not go. How can the first salary I earn? I can't even go give pastor. He's called the man of God. He's sent by God. He represents God. But when he was speaking to in your life, it was working. You didn't see him as a man. But now you have made the money. Now he's a what? A man. When you are dying, you come to him. He prayed for you. You answer. You don't see him as a, you see him as a man of God. But now it's time for you to return to tell God, thank you. How can I carry a whole video, a whole television, a whole fridge, and give to a man like me? He said, Ezekiel 44:30. He said, when you give your first fruit, he said, the priest, he didn't say he got. He said, the priest will cause the blessing to do what? To rest upon your house. So many of us, the blessings of God is not in our house. And the Bible said, the blessings of God make it rich and add no what? Sorrow. When first fruit is what? The blessing will not only rest on you, but it will enter your house and stay. Blessing is a spirit. He makes life begin to fall onto you in places and places. So I hear. He said, when you refuse to, when you withhold that of God, where do you withhold? You withhold in tithe. Malachi 3:10. He said, bring you all the tithe. So that there will be what? There will be money to service this piano when it's back. There will be money to service this AC that is cooling you. There will be money to buy the television to fix it when they need it. There will be money to put diesel in the generator so that my house will not lack goodies. So when you do it, he said, try me. I will also open opportunity for you and pour you just one thing, a blessing. Just a one thing, a blessing. One door I will open for you, will give you multiple streams of income. Sir, here. Which area are you withholding God? In Haggai 1:6 to 7, you ignore You ignore, say you have so much and bring in little. You eat, but you have not enough. You drink, but you are not filled with drink. Why? He said you clothe, but there is no room warm. And he that eateth earneth wages, where is he putting the wages? He put it in a bag of hole. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. Give me verse, the next verse, verse 7. Okay, you put it in, let me have the next verse, verse 8. I don't understand what you people are doing there. I don't get it. Go up to the mountain and do what? And bring wood and build my house. Take care of my house and I will take pleasure in it. Then I will be glorified, says the Lord. Then I will give you what you are looking for. If you refuse to take care of the house of God, the needs of the house of God, you don't bother about your pastor had it. You even wait after service to collect from your pastor, you're under a curse. Don't get to know what is going on now. They're teaching you. This pastor, he cook food and give. I will not cook food and give you. I will not cook. If a need, a day come, I feel like to do it. But to do it, to feel, to, because I will not do it. It's not written anywhere in the Bible. It's not written anywhere in the Bible. Give your life to Christ. Nobody should use bread and sugar to make you receive Christ. Receive him, if not, your soul will perish in hell. Receive him. Nobody use bread to entice me to repent. My Christianity is solid. You can't deceive me by the Spirit of God. Am I talking to you? So take care of the house of God. Ecclesiastes 11:1-6. He says, cast your bread upon many waters. You will find it after. I'm interested in verse 2. Ecclesiastes 11:2-6. I'm sorry, this time you got me. 2 and 6. He said, give to one. Yeah, give a portion to 7 and also to 8, for thou knowest not what evil shall be on the earth. You say you will not do. He told you again, sow your seed in the morning, in the evening withhold not your hand, for thou knowest whether the one you give in the morning will prosper, or the one you give in the evening will prosper, or all of them will work together for your good. You say I'm not going to give. When it comes to giving, you begin to hear God. Look at a man, Abraham, in Genesis 22, verse 1. God commanded him. He said, carry your son, your only son. He said, give it to me as a sacrifice. The man did not confer with flesh and blood. He carried his son immediately and went. And when he did, the Bible said in verse 12, he said, give me verse 12. He said, now I know you cannot withhold anything from me. He said, seeing thou hast no withhold that son, that only son from me, then nothing will be withhold from you. How many times we withhold what is due for God? If you want to give God, you make sure you look for money that is torn and drop in the hands of God. That is how your destiny is torn. I will show you in the Bible where the Bible says Malachi 3. He says you should not carry anything that is torn and give to God. You look for the one that rejected in the market, the sellotape is the one you give to God. You look for drink that have expired, is the one you give to God. Why are you doing that? He's a pastor, he's a man I'm giving now. You should be grateful I'm giving him 5 naira. No. You don't do that. Sir, don't do that. The Bible, the blessing came. Because you did not withhold, verse 16 and 17. He said, in blessing I will do what? I will bless. In multiply I will do what? I will multiply you. You must not withhold. You must not do what? You must not withhold. Luke 6:38, all of us know it. He said, if you release, it shall be what? Released back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, running over. How many people? Men, release back to your bosom. You don't want to release. Who will release to you? You don't want to give. Who will give to you? That is the scripture. Proverbs 11:24, he said, there is he that scattereth, yet does what? Increaseth. Proverbs 11:24. But there is he that withholdeth, but tendereth to what? Poverty. I will not withhold anymore. Number 5, when one is under demonic, okay, sorry, I'm through with that. The solution, I run it and I stop. Solution. Number 1, come to Jesus. Come to who? Jesus. Matthew 11:28. I need it in New Living. Matthew 11:28. Come to Jesus. Matthew 11:28. Come to him, all ye that are weary and are heavy laden. He said, Jesus said, come to me, all of you who are weary. Weary means you are tired of life and you are carrying loads that you've been trying to remove, you couldn't remove. He said, now if you come to me, what will I give you? I'll give you rest. It's only in Jesus you get rest. Tell your neighbors, only in Jesus you get rest. We saw it in Luke 5:5. He said to him, he said, we have toiled all night I will God nothing, but nevertheless, till what will I do? I will let down my net. And when he let down his net and accept Christ, what happened? His net began to break. He caught so many fishes. So come to Jesus. That is the only person that can give you life. Number two, obey divine instructions. What is the solution? Number two, obey what? Divine instruction. When you obey divine instruction, it will give you divine intervention and divine direction. Obey what? Divine instruction. Some of us, we don't like obeying divine instruction. Especially when instruction involves give. He said, I'm packing sticks so that I will bake it for me and my child to eat. He said, but go and get me the food. The one little one you have, go and bake it for me. So, what do you call it? Divine instruction. It's not palatable. And immediately he ate it. What happened? He encountered divine word intervention. Learn to obey divine instruction. Maybe God said to you, don't give me. Go to carry food and go and give to so-so person. He said, I never eat, finish, talk of to give her. How much more this one where her mouth they go free with for compound? Obey divine instruction. It might be a shoe you bought. You are admiring it. Like God said, remove it the same way you are admiring it. Go and give it. And the person tell you to give, the person not even stop at work. Now somebody where they walk, but not this shoe. He said, this particular shoe, maybe he's testing you in order to give to you what you are asking for. Obey divine instruction. Number three, render service in his house. Exodus 8:1. Render what? Service in his house. Render what? Service. The only people that God free from captivity are people who want to serve him. If you are coming here just to receive and go, nothing. But you are coming here, you want to work for God. What will I do? I love this fellowship. What can I do? I can sing. I can be in the ushery. I can be in the sanctuary. I know sound. I know about social media. I like this woman ministry, but there's something I can offer. So, what such people, Exodus 8:1 said, he said, let my people go so that they will serve me. Anytime you volunteer to serve God, God will command any powers holding you to let you do what? Go. Say, let my people go so that they may serve me. You can't be in bondage and serve him. Nobody serve two masters at the same time. Do you? It's not possible. So let him go. Let him serve me. Number four solution. And then the last. Remain in his presence. Psalm 91, 1-4. Remain in his presence. Me that dwell in the secret place of the Most High God shall do what? Abide under the word shadow of the Almighty. And I will say of the Lord, is my refuge, my fortress, my God, in whom will I trust? Surely he will do what? Deliver me from the snare, the traps of the fowler, and from the noisy pestilence. He will cover me with his feathers. Under his wings shall I do what? Trust and depend. Why? Because you dwell in the presence of the Most High God. Learn to remain there. Love the presence of God. Every time you are rushing out for Telemundo, you are rushing out for Zero, you are rushing out to do everything, you are rushing out for business, you never, to stay in the presence of God is always a problem. But to stay in the presence of Big Brother Niger, it's no problem. To stay in the presence of WrestleMania, it's no problem. To stay in the presence of football, it's no problem. To stay in the presence of your favorite cartoon problem. No. But to stay in the presence of God everywhere is a shame. You don't love my presence, but you love my blessing. How? Why are you raping me? Some of us rape God every day. Finally, where we stand up, number five. You have need of patience. You have need of what? Patience. You have need of patience. You have it. Hebrews 10:35 and 36. You have need of patience. After you have done this, allow patience in your life. Cast not away, therefore. Please, yes, give me scriptures like this. Cast not away, therefore, your confidence, which had great recompense of what? Reward. Don't cast it away. For you have need of what? Patience, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. Let's be upstanding. I believe you are clapping for